Bed slide and rear living super slide park kept cougar just coming in here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. This RV saw one owner. It has, other than the, I don't know, 10 minutes from the factory to the dealership that sold it, to the campsite where it was parked, it's never been towed, so it's been mostly park kept its whole life. Overall, pretty sharp shape. Couple little glitches here and there, but nothing that I think is, you know, worth getting our blood pressure up too far. The tires do probably need to be replaced, which is pretty common on park kept units of this age. But overall, I think you're gonna like what you see. Now, if you've seen any of my used RV videos, you know that I follow the old idea of if you see something, say something, and I get elephants out of the room. So we're going to begin inside with addressing what we're looking at right here. When the folks put it away this last fall, she was fine. Then we experienced yet another Michigan polar vortex winter, and Mother Nature unfortunately stretched her enough that we got a little bit of a cold crack right here. So the question becomes, what can you do? Well, you put a little glue under it, you put some heavy weight on it, you let that glue cure. And visibly, you're always going to know that was there, but in terms of function, it doesn't hurt the RV whatsoever. Now, the folks use this as a seasonal summertime camper, so you notice how the floor vents have little covers on them. They didn't camp when it was cold. This was their, spring, summer, fall destination getaway. So, they never really used the heating system on it. Other than that, you know, the air seems to work. All the major appliances seem to work. They spent most of their time just hanging out, sitting in their chairs. Let me spin us around right here. This is an airbed style hide bed. They put a little blanket on the back of it so that when the chairs were stacked up on that sofa for transit, which is how you're supposed to do it in this floor plan, they weren't scuffing anything. And I love the fact that they still went to that kind of length even though they were done with the RV. All the windows are going to open for airflow, including these really large slide side breeze windows. You do have dual section day and night shades. I did notice a couple of the nightshade sections want to bunch up in a funny way when I put them up, but they still work just fine. And when you put them down, that all goes away. If you're facing the bed from the bedroom entry door, the left side bed window shade just needs restrung. So that's just a thing. If I go through this RV and present these videos, I try to look at it as if I was going to buy it. So if there's even a little thing that I notice, I do try to point it out. Like, oh, the main folding entry door handle has been removed because the owners, I believe, might have had a deck or something next to it, but they didn't need it, so they just got it out of the way effectively. Big classic style, you know, I say classic. 10 years ago, this is what they did, but I guess that's classic in RV terms, but having this overhead kitchen cabinet that bumps out toward you, it has fallen out of favor in the RV business because it feels big and bulky, but which is fine. I sound like I'm repeating myself. If you saw our other videos from recently, I also had a real similar living room Rockwood camper come in that, kind of singing the same tune on it. But more and more buyers felt like these bulky overhead cabinets were in the way and made the RV feel small, but I have always been in favor of finding more storage rather than less. You can see the previous owners still have the sink covers over here. They've got the stovetop cover. Great spot for a wastebasket down here. And if you're curious as to why that panel's hanging loose under the stove, that's because that is where things like your water pump are, and this RV is winterized. That's your winterization access point right there. Check out this pantry and bonus drawers here. It's as big as the refrigerator. Now, we can look at the door of it, but if I pop this thing open, you suddenly go, oh, wow, holy crap, Martha, there's quite a bit of storage in here. Last year, it was holy crap, Batman. I've noticed this year I'm on a holy crap, Martha kick. Granted, in, Batman v. Superman, Martha was Batman's mother's name, so whatever. I got way off topic on this one. Regardless, here in the bathroom, we've got a walk-through mid-bath. But we've got a nice bonus closet in here, and I almost said little, but frankly, there's nothing little about that. That's bigger than the closets in the master bedroom. Easy standing corner shower, and if you look up here, the power vent is actually doubling as the skylight in this model. That's kind of a pretty common classic camper thing that you don't see it as much anymore, especially not in Cougars, but nothing wrong with it. It gets the job done. Big sink, though, and I do like the counter space there. And if you're a bigger fella like me, person plus fella equals person, you are going to have plenty of leg room in front of this toilet right here. Now, this is an aftermarket replacement residential queen bed here. Big, thick, puffy job. But if you really look, you see how much space is on each side of that bed? You could probably stuff a king in there, a 70-inch wide king, no sweat. So all the windows are on the bed also open. That is the window shade at great length I was trying to describe earlier. It just doesn't go up and down right now because a string got popped. But this is what's cool about this floor plan. You're getting a fifth wheel bedroom in a potentially, with the right truck, half-ton towable travel trailer. The biggest thing with half-tons is just checking the length and the tongue weight on this with the bed slide versus your payload. If you don't know what your truck can handle, give us a call. We'll make sure you're safe, guys, you know. Just like, you know, a classic Cougar fifth wheel bedroom. You've got that huge 8-foot wide wardrobe up front and just a great amount of large dresser space on here. Those big drawers, you could really pack full of stuff. And, of course, that second entry door means, you know, if someone's in the bathroom, you need to hop up, you know, into the bedroom or, you know, get to the living room from the bedroom. You can, anytime. You're never cut off from anything in this camper. Back outside, it is a beautiful London day here at Haylett RV with the constant little soul-crushing drizzle. Behind the propane cover, you see a couple white things sort of stacked up, stuffed up, wadded up there. Those are the spare tire covers that the previous owners used. And you might notice, too, how all the decals and everything really look pretty good. I'm not seeing, like, peeling, flaking decals, kind of like the inside. Overall, it's been well kept. You know, when it wasn't in use, it was well maintained. I see, vent covers over the bathroom vents. The skin still has a pretty decent gleam to it, although with the rain and the humidity in the air right now, you can't get the best view of that, but you can see how the decals are not falling apart. As I mentioned at the kind of the start of the video, the tires are, they're not shot, but guys, you should probably plan on getting them replaced. So just kind of keep that in mind. The RV, they're the original factory tires that hasn't been towed. They've been sitting in one spot. It happens, you know, any tire. Frankly, this RV at this age, you should probably have replaced the original factory tires anyway. You can walk all over the roof. Even has walkable slide boxes. As a Cougar dealer, we've got a pretty good grasp on this thing. This was made back when they were doing that slide out rear bike rack cargo bumper thing that never fully caught on in the RV industry. I think it was just a little too heavy and unwieldy for most folks. But the fact is, if you're looking for a place to keep some extra stuff, you got a nice spot right there. Power awning makes setting camp pretty darn simple and easy. This does have an enclosed heated belly. Now, until the really August of 2018 and forward, Cougar travel trailers were not 0-degree rated as they are now. So this is what would be known as extended season rating. Hold on. I'm trying to see. Okay. I wasn't sure if these white lines in these graphics were cracked decals or if they were just the actual decal, and they're the actual decal trying to outline mountains. Before I wrap this thing up, if I saw something, I wanted to say something, because that's just the kind of dealership that we are here at Haylett RV. So there you have it. If you swap some tires on it, take this thing down the road, lickety split, no problem. To, you know, fifth wheel bedroom in a travel trailer, which is really nice. The other side of that is if you want to just find your own little park spot for it, as long as you're not driving 90 mile an hour, you take it home the way it is, it'd probably be just fine. So, give us a call. We do hitching, pieces, parts, finance, trades, package deals, everything in between. Screwed up my own tagline. So take care, stay safe, have fun, and happy camping, everyone.